lot of you who are into K-pop probably know this group called EXO. I myself don't really listen to their music, but they have a pretty large fan base. So one of their fans thought it'd be a bright idea to break into EXO's dorm and steal a bunch of shit. And what confuses me is not the fact that they broke into their dorm to steal shit, but the fact that of all of the things they could have taken, they thought the best thing to take was their urine. Like, I honestly can't even process this. See, in my opinion, normal people would take things like maybe clothes, shoes, or even leftover food or some shit like that. But someone's urine? Like, just why? And above that, the fan froze the urine and quote-unquote did that so that it wouldn't spoil and that it was slightly sour. Okay, you know what? To freeze and preserve it, we've established that you have some sort of weird fetish, so I can kind of understand that. Now, this is the part I don't get, and I could just be overanalyzing things, but I was under the impression that sour pertains to taste, meaning that you would have had to have tasted the urine to know that it's sour. And this is a point where I just really don't understand it. Like, is this the extent that people will go through to prove their loyalty to these K-pop groups by consuming their urine? God, this is gonna get me all sorts of restrictions, but that has got to be the strangest fan story I've read by far. And I'm not even surprised when people do dumb things like sell used celebrity tissues on eBay or other crazy things like that. So an equally grotesque thing happened to a 2PM rapper. His name is Taegyeon, but I'm probably pronouncing his name wrong. But anyways, one of his fans sent him a letter, and you see, why would we write letters with normal things like pens, pencils, or markers when we have this natural free thing called our period blood? This is probably where BuzzFeed got their video idea, to be honest. But basically, this fan wrote a letter in her period blood and basically sprinkled it with a couple strands of her pubes because I guess the period blood wasn't artistic enough, and she sent it to the guy. Of course, the fandom tracked her down and basically attacked her, calling her a fake fan, which I don't even know where they got that from. But to prove her loyalty, she took a picture with her bloody panties to show that she wasn't faking anything. I don't know where she's from, but we have places for people like this in the States that can hopefully find a solution for where she comes up with these disgustingly creative ideas. And you see, normally I'm not shy when it comes to ranting, but stories like these really do have a way with leaving me speechless. Let's just look at the more popular K-pop groups. I'm talking BTS, GOT7, EXO, Girls' Generations, Blackpink, etc. I've noticed a lot of their fandoms like to shit talk other fandoms and attack each other as if it's on behalf of their favorite K-pop group slash idol. Like, for example, you'll see BTS armies attacking the EXOLs over who's the better K-pop group or who has the better songs. Honestly, I equate that to a Belieber shit talking a Harry Styles fan over whoever has the better music slash songs. Like, the artists don't even have a problem with each other, but for some reason the fandoms do. See, to me that doesn't make any sense. And this isn't even a thing between other fandoms. Like, they'll even attack each other within their own fandom, and it's like a competition of who knows the most about their favorite K-pop group. And I'm not talking normal, almost sane things like what's their age, their height, or where are they from. No, I'm talking what's their blood type, what primary school did they go to, or what's their parents' phone number and address. Another thing I've noticed, which will definitely offend the large majority, is that most popular K-pop groups aren't really that innovative with their songs. Literally take any American slash UK boy band or girl band, take the types of songs they sing, translate them into Korean, and you have yourself a K-pop song. Of course, a lot of Korean groups put a lot of effort into their performance, dancing, and style, and of course a lot of these popular groups have songs that aren't so Western orientated, but sorry to me when I see a boy band with a song that's flexing about how they want big cars and lots of money. Korean or English, I still think of that as being very cliche and pretty much uncreative. But this just leads me into the next reason why I don't really get K-pop fandoms. If you dare criticize anything about a specific K-pop group, you are not worthy of their fandom. You'll be rejected out of that fandom like a fucking college application. Say goodbye to being a Blink, an XOL, an ARMY, a VIP. Because as a member of that fandom, your job is to like and agree with every single thing your K-pop idol says or does, because, you know, logic. This is the last, but by far one of the most bothersome things about K-pop fandoms. They do things solely because of their K-pop idols. Like, they moved to Korea because of their K-pop idols. They learned to play an instrument because of their K-pop idols. Like, there's this Puma ad of a BTS rapper. Basically, he's playing the piano to one of their songs. But again, it's an ad, so it wasn't even meant to be an artistic piece per se. But tell me why this is the large majority of the comments on that video. So you're wanting to learn the piano because your favorite idol plays the piano. What in the world? Like, this isn't even inspiration either. Like, people move to Korea because of their favorite K-pop idol. They look for a Korean partner because of their favorite K-pop idol. These are big life decisions you're making. So I highly doubt that wanting to learn to play the piano because your bias plays the piano isn't linked to some kind of obsessive fan disorder. Personally speaking, I've been in and out of this whole K-pop thing. The music is interesting. The performances are usually dope, but to warrant fans who do dumb things like I've mentioned, like, sorry, K-pop is good, but it's not revolutionary. Big house, big cars, and big rings.